Good evening, the audience and the Toyotatimes athletes. Now, I'm Morita Kyonosuke, the main newscaster, and I'm Kozuka Takahiko, representing athletes. And welcome back, Mr. Kozuka. We have a special that would best suit it for you. I don't want to be replaced by Mr. Ashida. I will be aggressive. What a smug face. But let's relax. And during Tokyo Paralympic Games, every day from 7 p.m. Japan time, we continue to support 234 GTTAs in 47 countries and region. This is the sixth day of the Toyotatimes athletes now, and the more GTTAs are successful, will be more and more engrossed in Paralympic Games. How about you? Yes, in fact, I realized that I only had a very thin slice of information. I was also told that my comments were too light. Yes, I'm a bit anxious about that. And also, I look at SNS of athletes, and that shows personality characteristics of those athletes. And watching this program, we can get many information, and I'm looking forward to today's program as well. We are sharing information of 66 GTTAs that will be joining Tokyo Paralympic Games, and we have English version as well with the simultaneous translation. Once a live streaming is over, then there will be the archive on YouTube. Therefore, 13 programs are going to be the kind of database for you to check up about the Paralympic Games. Yes. So, for instance, the glove throw, you may be adjust the turning your back and throw it backward. So whenever we are interested in something unique about Paralympic Games, we can look at the particular program. Yes, in that sense, today we are featuring para-athletes competing in both the summer and winter games, and there are in fact numerous para-athletes. To be a top athlete in one sport is already challenging, and there are those the outstanding athletes who would challenge another sport, and therefore, at the time of the Winter Paralympic Games, you might see some familiar face, and then please come back to the archive. And since you are the winter athlete, hope that you would share with us your expert view, again, that look on your face. And in fact, you have a strong supporter today, the Mr. Marie Taiki Alpine skier, will be joining with us. Yes, I understand that he will be accessing us from overseas, and we're going to introduce the appeal of the those versatile para athletes. Make sure to add hashtag Toyotatimes Live or Toyotatimes Live in English, and sending your message of support to athletes. And also, we are looking forward to your comments either on YouTube or in Instagram. Yeah, the many viewers are welcoming you back, Mr. Kozuka. So today we will make a deep dive again into the appeal of the para sports. Hope that you will stay with us until the end. From now on, I'd like to share with you the results of the GTTAs. And the GTTA names and the regions are in red. Starting from yesterday, T63, Wagner of Denmark, he received the bronze medal in long jump. He said he wanted to be better, and therefore he is going to race in 100 meters as well. And also T54, men's 400 meter on wheelchair. The Tahati of Finland, he was not qualified, finishing eighth, but he is going to aim at 100 meters. That's his main race. And T13 means 100 meter. This is for the athlete with the visual impairment without the guide. And Jason Smith of Ireland is going to participate in the final. And wheelchair rugby, the Canada of with the Caldwell, and the France. There was a GTTA match, and Canada won. And yesterday, the Australia, where Bat belongs, they lost to USA in semifinals, and today they lost to Japan, and therefore they could not win the medal. wheelchair basketball, a first in men's Premier League. USA, they lost with the slightest margin against the UK, but today they won over Australia. And Canada with Gunson, they're going to play a game against Korea. And in the case of the Women's Premier League, they lost to Germany, and they're going to be in the final game for them against Australia. And next, wheelchair tennis, the Fernandez of Argentina made a first win over Spanish player and Mr. Miki as well. And now today, in the men's singles, De La Puente of Spain, he won over Poland, a Polish athlete, and Miki won over Argentina athlete. And this is a photo sent by Mr. Miki. He is together with De La Puente. They are friends playing the game as well. And they encountered in the venue, and yeah, they show a very good smile. And furthermore, about wheelchair tennis, today, the men's doubles, Fernandez is going to play against Miki's pair, and also De La Puente as well. His pair is going to meet with the American pair tonight. And next, swimming, para-swimming, women's 300-meter individual medley, SM8, Jessica Long, she won gold medal. The USA's Long, this is a second medal. She might win more. And in the women's 100-meter breaststroke, SB5, Rung, she finished sixth. And today, the para-swimming, men's 400-meter freestyle, S7, the two GTGAs raced, and the Gabalan of the Philippines finished sixth, and the Sun finished number seven. And now the bronze medal that went to Lopez Diaz, a men's 50-meter backstroke, S3, and S4, men's 100-meter breaststroke qualification, Tsapatakis of Greece. He was qualified to finish the third. And fencing, there are many more. First, from yesterday, Category B, a woman's full individual. There was a reproduction of the final in Rio de Janeiro, and Vio of Italy, and Jinjin of China. They met again, and Vio won gold medal again, and Jinjin received silver medal. Congratulations. This is during the ceremony, and you see that those two GTGAs are congratulating with each other. That really make us happy, and this is not the end. Now, this is about today, for the wheelchair fencing, the women's four team semifinals, Jinjin of China, her team was qualified to proceed by winning over Hong Kong. And Vio, if her team wins against Hungary, then they would once again meet in final. So there will be another GTGA competition. And triathlon, four out of Toyota 7 raced today. A first men's PTWC, the Platt on wheelchair. He was the overwhelming champion in gold medal. Now look at this picture, and please note the arm. You see the blood vessels there. That's because of the pump-up. It was right after the race, yes. Because for the bike and run, he uses his arms. That's why. And you know that he is going to race in para-cycling again on September the 1st. And Morale of Spain, women's PTWC, this is her first Paralympic Games, and she received the bronze medal. And there are two more. PGS5, men's, the Daniel of Canada received bronze medal. And women's PGSW, Le Monsieur of France, was the ranked sixth. That's for the Ancancon, Schneider, Platt. Three won gold medals, and Daniel and Morrow received the bronze medals and the other the athletes also finished among top six, and therefore we should remember the GTTAs for the next Paralympic Games as well. They are so competitive. And the football five aside, they made a very good start. Brazil won over China. And the para-rowing, the Bouge of France, she finished ninth. This is the class with the milder impairment. And Skarstein of Norway in women's single sculls, she finished first to receive gold medal. This is the fourth Paralympic Games, including Pyeongchang Winter Games, and this is her first gold medal. That's all about the results of the GTTAs.
Today's special feature. The shock of all-rounder athletes, para-athletes are tackling on summer and winter. This year, I often hear about this bi-player or all-rounder. I was surprised to hear there are para-athletes participating in both the summer and winter games. Can we really do that? Kozuka-san, you are a figure skater, a winter Olympian. From your viewpoint, can you imagine yourself being in one of the summer Olympic sports? Well, I first imagine is the four-year cycle. So I imagine myself in a four-year cycle, how I can aim for Olympic, but if I'm going to aim for the Winter Games too, it will be a two-year cycle. So winter and summer, two-year cycle. So after the summer games, 2 years, I will continue training for the summer games and then again the winter games. So of course, I'll continue both maybe, but then it's like I can practice. I have only half the time for training, so I might have to work out double. Can I really do that? How are they doing that? That intense training? Thinking about that, it's really hard for me to imagine. Well, say if you are able to train for both summer and winter, what kind of sport do you wish to work on other than figure skating? For example, maybe gymnastics. I think it's very close, maybe close to figure skating. Maybe there are judges and they give us a certain score. So maybe I think there could be some kind of relationship, I thought. So maybe I can work on rhythmic gymnastics, for example. So there's affinity with figure skating. But I once talked to someone in gymnastics, but how they jump, they told me. But for figure skating, it's like we sort of stop our body once and then bounce ourselves. But in rhythmic gymnastics, they need to turn by themselves, and then that turn will make your body follow. So even if we say jump and turn, it's very different. For figure skating, we close our legs, but for rhythmic gymnastic, we shouldn't close our legs completely, but rather keep a space in between. So this type of little difference, how we move our body. So I believe that my technique-wise, it must be very difficult. So the schedule and the physical aspect, there's an obstacle, or it's very difficult to work both on summer and winter. However, there are six GTTA who compete both the summer and winter games. Let's get to know them today and tomorrow. Today, we're going to talk about three athletes. First is Cindy Ouellet from Canada. Left shows the picture from summer wheelchair basketball, and the right is the winter games cross-country skiing. She participated in three events in Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018, overcoming bone cancer, which she was diagnosed at age 12. She has become a powerful athlete. Her motto is seize the moment. Tokyo is her fourth Paralympic, following Beijing, London, and Rio, and it is her fifth if we include the winter games. No medal yet. This time in Tokyo, I believe that she's really aiming for a medal. Wheelchair basketball, the Canadian team preliminary round, three match finishes, and tonight against Australia, that's the final match, and they will be aiming for the final round. Looking at her Instagram, yes, I checked her Instagram. I have information from Instagram again. Yeah, that's important. We can see a picture like this. She's really good at playing the piano, so she can go three ways. A talented player, cross-country skiing, wheelchair basketball, and piano. Oh, okay. So we can find her third talent through Instagram. You always look at Instagrams, Kozuka-san. Yes. Yes, yes, I really like to watch it. And there's a comment saying, I want Kozuka-san doing rhythmic gymnastics. Well, I think my body, even when I was an active athlete, I wasn't really flexible enough. So that is why I don't think I can do it. Okay, well, next. Let me introduce the next athlete, Daniel Wagner of Denmark. Left shows picture in summer athletics, long jump, and right is snowboard in winter. So in the summer games, London 2012, it was his first try in long jump and he got bronze. And in Rio, he added 100 meter and won silver medal. And 2 years later in Pyeongchang, he was a flag bearer of Team Denmark. At age 14, due to injury, his right leg was amputated. And this time in Tokyo, he won a bronze medal yesterday in long jump T63, a class using prosthesis. And he will be in 100 meter tonight, today. And also, Wagner came to Japan in July 2018 as a guest player in Japan Para-Athletics Championships. World top class athletes were participating, and Wagner ranked first in both 100 meter and long jump. He also communicated with Toyota employees who came to cheer and handed out flags of Denmark and signed postcards. So he will be in 100 meters soon, and he really came to Japan and communicated. I think he will have more fans in Japan too. It's a very good communication. And looking at his Instagram, he loves RAV4. Wow, a cool car. We can see on his roof and side view mirror, there's a flag of Denmark. Very unique design. Yeah, it's so cool. Okay, you have lots of information gained from Instagram. Yes, yes. I always look at my cell phone. People say don't look at your phone too much. But yes, well, it's good that you bring us lots of information. Para athletes competing both summer and winter. The third athlete is from Japan, Muraoka Momoka. She began her athlete life as in alpine skiing, but she took up the challenge for athletics 100 meter. Tokyo is her first summer games. In Pyeongchang 2018, she earned a medal in all the events she participated, 1 gold, 2 silver, and 2 bronze. 1 year after that, 2019 May, she announced that she will go into athletics too. And just 2 months after that, she has the Japan record of 100 meter T54 class. An incredible athlete. Yeah, just after starting, just 2 months, and she's able to set a record. Well, as Kozuka-san said, working on both summer and winter, not enough time, but making a decision and working on it 2 months, earning a record. Summer Olympic this time, Tokyo 2020, it was extended for 1 year. But usually, yes, what she's done is 2 months, and then she was able to set a record. Alpine skiing, I didn't have an image that we use our upper body that much, so I thought it might be difficult to work on the athletics. But what could be the difficulty? We want to learn more. We would like to ask about our Toyota family members to our fellow Toyota family member. First time we have someone on live from overseas. We have Alpine skier Morii Taiki. Good evening. Or should we say good afternoon? Where are you now? Yes, I'm in Switzerland now. Wow. Oh, you try to show us the view? Can you see it? Oh, yeah. We can see the mountains. Looks really like you are in Switzerland, and you are really in Switzerland, right? Yeah, you're in training camp? Yes. We are in Zasfe and 3,600 meter elevation, and we are doing skiing camp. So The elevation is about the same as Mount Fuji, the highest mountain in Japan. So during your training camp, I know you must be busy, but we have a special feature on Muraoka Momoka. We will have to hear your comments. Let me introduce to you briefly about Mr. Morii. Mr. Morii is an alpine skier, same as Muraoka-san, and a member of TMC External Affairs Division from Salt Lake City 2002 to Pyeongchang 2018. He has been gaining 4 silver medals and 1 bronze medal. So I heard that Morii-san, you're like an older brother to Muraoka-san. So how did you get to know each other? Yeah, when Momoka was really, really small, like this. Oh, so small. Well, maybe a little bit bigger. Well, she was skiing, and when she came into the team, it's like we've been spending half a year all together going to many places for competition. So you know a lot about Muraoka-san. What is she like? Her characteristic? Yeah, she's really easygoing, relaxing mood. However, I think that she's very determined. For example, the time schedule is set in a very detailed way, but she memorizes everything. And I asked her, like, when should I start the men's team? And then she will let me know, well, it will start so and so time. So she knows a lot and she has really good memory. And she's really like an idol in our team. Yeah, we see a picture of you too. You can see it too, Morii-san. Yes, yes. When did you take this picture? I think it was Japan Championship when I went to support her. You have a camera in your hand. Yes, yes, I love taking pictures. So I only take pictures of Momoka, basically. Yeah, I love to take her pictures. Yeah, it's like a professional camera that you're holding. So you go to support her and take wonderful pictures of her. So you went there not as your professional sport, but as a part of your private life. Yes, I actually went to the same venue. Yes, so maybe on the left side of Muraoka-san, I'm there. I was actually on that spot. So Muraoka-san decided to aim for Tokyo after Pyeongchang, but why did that happen? Yes, when I heard she seeked advice from me, I want to aim for Tokyo, but I said, yes, go for it. Why? Because when I first met Momoka, I met her at the ski area, but she was dashing on a slope, and I raced with her, and I completely lost against her. And ski too, she is truly talented, but wheelchair racing too, I know that she has a talent. So I thought that she can do athletics too. So that is why when asked me, I said, yes, go take up the challenge.
Well, I was talking with Kozuka-san. So once reaching a top level player in Winter Games and then turn to summer and tackle completely different sport. What could be the motivation behind that? First and foremost, I thought that's because this is going to take place in her home country, hometown Tokyo. Yes. And in fact, there was the send-off party within the company, and I asked about that to her. Frankly speaking, I know, that was extremely challenging and demanding. Yet, I decided to aim at Tokyo Paralympic Games. So, to me, one dream came true. I achieved one goal and I'm very happy right now. As she just stated, it is because in Tokyo. And therefore, one dream came true for her. I see, yes. Yet, alpine skiing is overwhelmingly different from the track and field in wheelchair. I tend to imagine that for alpine skiing, you don't use a lot of muscle power and upper body. What can you say? That's completely wrong. Or rather, I would say that those two sports are completely different. You know that in the case of alpine skiing, you don't have to use your energy for skiing. Well, as in the case of the track and field, you have to act as an engine to move yourself. So that's completely different. So one's own body as an engine. So in the case of the wheelchair ski, or the chair ski rather, you use the gravity, and your main task is to control that. Well, as in the case of the wheelchair, the racing, you start from the where the wheelchair is stopped, and therefore you have to go through completely different training, right? You mentioned that she consulted with her, and you agreed right at the moment. And frankly, what came up to your mind? I knew it was an enormous task. If she could be qualified for the Olympic Games, I thought that was enormous, and yet she did it. So I'm very proud of a young sister, so to speak. That's right, as an old brother. And at the same time, as she challenged the new sport, I hear that you were also aiming at competition in Tokyo Olympic Games for powerlifting. Did you realize something about differences between the summer and winter games? Yes, I came to realize that it's extremely demanding. You know that the time when you have to reach a peak in terms of your ability and strength for alpine skiing, that was completely different from the summer games. And in during the power lifting, that also showed the difference because you have to rely on your arm strength alone. I realized that I was heavily relied on the tool and the gear that I use, and therefore I had even stronger affection to the sport that I'm engaged in. Oh, I see. So that gave you the opportunity to renew your love about the sport that you have been engaged in. I see. You're supported and helped by the gears and tools you use. Well, regardless of whether it is Olympic or Paralympic Games, you use games and tools. For instance, in the case of the 100-meter sprint, you put on shoes. So in a way, everybody is supported by their shoes. So I think it is good for us to renew our awareness about what we are daily doing. Yeah, that gave you the opportunity to renew your awareness about the competition that you've been engaged in. As you have been watching Muraoka from she was young, what are the strengths of her? There are a lot. First of all, she's so skillful in using her body muscle and body. And also, I would say that she has a very highly sensitive sensor. In the case of the chair ski, there is a sensor to identify or check the center of gravity. You have to put your center of gravity right in the middle of the chair. And when she says this is a center, that's exactly the center of gravity. Well, as in my case, what I thought as a center of gravity is about 2 to 3 millimeter different. Excuse me, 3 millimeter, that is good enough, I think. Yeah, I think I would say that's quite excellent. Being a top level skier, you have such a great sense, and yet your body can detect where your body is positioned. That's right. And that would be utilized for chair skiing. And what about the track and field? Do you think that would be also applicable? Yes. Because you are on a wheelchair, how to use your body part and how to move your body, I think for that purpose, that kind of in-body sensor could be utilized. In other words, she's good at knowing the level and status of her body. for instance, when you raise your arms the horizontally, and can you tell that they are right at the horizontal level? You are just relying on your sense, and that's so difficult. And now that she decided to compete in Summer Games as well, so you supported her decision. And what was your impression when you first saw her racing in the championship? Yes, I was very much impressed. Well, because that was the first time to see her racing in the wheelchair. And also, just like in the case of skiing, I realized that there was a moment when she switched on her the motivation, so to speak, right before the race, and that was same. And I really liked that facial expression. Since your old brother, so to speak. And in March this year, there was the National Para Athletics Championship. And together with Mori-san, we'd like to see that the video. Starting from the 100 meters, the lane 6, a third from the left, that's her. She's already very fast. Mori-san, she did a very good initial spurt, right? Yes. The initial spurt, that's where she's good at. So I hope that she will do that again in Olympic Games as well. And finish in a good the ranking, good position. Watching the film, right at the moment of the start, the other racers, competitors are left behind. Why is she so fast? Well, she did a training to pump up her body. And in fact, I would say that her body is the larger than when she was the alpine skier. And in March, there was an Asian Cup. When she was the skiing again, I felt there was a good synergy because she was so powerful in her skiing as well. I know in terms of the scheduling of the two sports, that would be very difficult. At the same time, there is a good synergy. And in fact, you have to produce a synergy. Yes, when you challenge different sports, you realize what is not adequate in terms of your abilities. What are your shortcomings? Well, thank you very much, old brother, to Momoka-san. And now the message of support to her from Switzerland. Yes. Hope that she will race through and finish it, and at the same time enjoy it without any regret. And if she could enjoy it from the beginning to the end, then I'm sure there will be a very good result. And the competition of athletes that are dedicated to those races that would move us all around the world. And I'd like to send the cheer up message from Switzerland. How long are you staying in Switzerland? 7th of September, that's when I leave Switzerland. So after you come back, hope that there will be the opportunity for you to celebrate her. And also, I'm looking forward to Beijing Paralympic Games. Yes, me too. Well, thank you very much, Mori-san, once again. Thank you. Yeah, it was good to ask about Muraoka from Mori-san. We sense the love to her. Yes, he likes her so much. And in fact, there are some messages about that. Well, how he's going to watch her race, I'm sure he will be most nervous. So that's what we'd like to keep in mind when we cheer her up in the race. There will be the qualification and the final on Wednesday, September 1st, 100 meter T54. And also, she will be possibly competing in 400 meter universal relay for qualification and final for September 3rd. That's all about those wonderful athletes competing both in winter and summer.
And finally, tonight and tomorrow's schedule of GTTA Global Team Toyota Athletes. First of all, tonight, athletics. Yesterday, we introduced to you 100-meter T64 single-leg prosthesis knee below. Johnny Peacock aiming for three consecutive gold and Wallace USA currently in the world rank number 2 and 100-meter T63 prosthesis single above knee. So gold medalist in long jump Wagner will be here tonight, preliminary, tomorrow the finals. And tomorrow's schedule, 1,500-meter T11. Severe visual impairment guide runner will be running along Castro, Ecuador, and Rosero. 5,000 meter, they are placed sixth, but here they want to aim for the first para medal as Ecuador. We want to cheer for them. And 100 meter T33 wheelchair racing, cerebral palsy. Yesterday we had a special feature, Alamutaridi. Rio gold medalist, second, aiming for second gold, and Suzuki Tomoki T54, 1,500-meter wheelchair, but athletes with no cerebral palsy. First Paralympic, what is he thinking now? And he will be going to other events too, 800-meter and marathon. And para-equestrian grade 4 team, we will be seeing Belgium Clay's had an individual set movement test bronze. So tomorrow, and you also have individual freestyle test. And Gongqing, Canada versus Colombia, the final match in the prelim, and Serio USA versus Algeria, the final match to proceed to the next round. And wheelchair tennis, Miki Takuya and De La Puente Fernandez, so they're Japan, Spain, Argentina, respectively. And depending on the result, Miki and De La Puente will be in singles and doubles. Fernandez will be in singles. Football five-a-side, Alves of Brazil. It will be their second match versus Japan. So Brazil has been winning four consecutive golds. Japan is their first Paralympic. They had a sweeping victory, both of them, in their first match. What's going to happen to this match? And para swimming for women's 4x100-meter freestyle relay, Cole from Australia, Rivard, Canada, Long, USA. It's going to almost start, and Australia Cole, they are going to compete a gold medal team of Rio. So we'll have an all-star competition. Tomorrow, men's 100-meter backstroke S7, Philippines Guaylan, and also women's 100-meter backstroke S9, Ellie Cole, and S6, 50-meter butterfly, Ireland Turner. It is her third event, but no medal yet. This is the most hopeful event, world rank second. Let's have our hopes high. And 200-meter individual medley, SM11 para swimming. This is the most severe visual impairment. It is the third event. Yesterday in the special feature, we showed that he's really good at the piano. Do you remember that? We would like to share with you the result tomorrow, Toyotatimes Athletes Now. Also, in our special website, we have our result and the schedule, interview video, and also we have an article about Muraoka-san that we had a special feature today. And athletes' Instagram and Twitter SNS information is also on a special website. If you're ever going to support them, don't forget the hashtag ToyotaTimesLive. Let's become one team through our support. Toyota Times Athletes Now, day 6. We had a program from 7 p.m. JST. We have lots of comments again today. Yes, Instagram comment, NGS11023. Working on two sports at world-class level, it's purely astounding, incredible, yes. YouTube comment, Deuchi-san. I want to have a bigger brother like Mori-san. Yes, he looks very gentle, but he has a very strong core, and he will give us a nudge whenever we cannot decide. Well, that's great. And Maju-san, athletes like cameras, it seems. Nikki-san too. likes camera. And how about you, Kozuka-san? I just use my smartphone camera. That's enough for my Instagram. Yep. And Ashida-san? Oh, Ashida-san. Each and every story is wonderful. Oh, Ashida-san, Ashida Hajimu, your rival? Yes, Ashida-san, thank you for watching our program. Yep, I picked up his comment, so I hope you will pick up my comment from tomorrow, too. Oh, President said, Kozuka-san, you see your smartphone too much, and sometimes you're scolded, or you see your... Yep, you're like a kid. Yep, I'm like a kid, I keep on challenging. Okay, that's all the comments today, thank you very much. Tomorrow's program, tomorrow's special feature, part two, the shock of all-rounder athletes, para-athletes are tackling on summer and winter. We have more dual players tomorrow, and we would like to also focus on the work of equipment development team. Toyota Gazoo Racing Europe, TGRE, recently won the Le Mans 24 Hours. We are able to have an interview with them. So we would like to learn more about them tomorrow. And tomorrow we will be welcoming Toyota's para-athlete Sato Keita, first time on our program. He is in Production Engineering Planning Division of TMC, and along with Ashida-san, he's an active GTTA who won the bronze medal in 4x100m relay in Rio 2016 with Ashida-san. So you did MC with him in Toyota's handoff gathering, right, Kozuka-san? Yeah, he really, really helped me out. If he wasn't there, I couldn't have made it. Yes, so same as Ashida-san, Sato-san will be explaining to us how we should watch the Paragames. Yes. Okay, Kozuka-san, are you right? There was a pause. Yeah, I couldn't read what I wrote. My handwriting was so messy. Yeah, that happens all the time. Toyotatimes athletes now ending. We will show you these images. The supportive message from Toyota workplaces to athletes. Well, Ashida-san yesterday said he was really moved by these images. So along with this image, we would like to hear Tokyo's summer song by Naoto Intirani. It was Morita Kyonosuke and Kozuka Takahiko. See you again 7 p.m. tomorrow. One Toyota. Myself, oh, with loneliness in my heart.